We are about to embark upon a series of strange and exciting, dangerous adventures. Adventures that will lead us to all parts of the world.
Hello and welcome to another Bad Comic Review. This time we are looking at Gene Roddenberry's Lost Universe, Issue 1. This is a series from Tekno Comix from 1995, based on a concept by Gene Roddenberry with additional character creation and development by Miguel Barrett Roddenberry and story development by DC Fontana. The actual writer was Lawrence Watt Evans, pencils by James Callahan, inks by Aaron McClellan, Ken Bruzenak, letterer Tony Kelly, colorist Kell-O-Graphics did the computer colors and films. Bill Sienkiewicz did the cover, which is pretty cool looking, kind of related. Raffer Scheinek was the in-house colorist. Erica Taguchi was the graphic designer, and James Chambers editor. So there's a lot of people who worked on this book. The book opens with this ship in space, and they're going to this guy Dr. Grange's planet, and he seems to be really intent on going home, but something's not quite right, and the pilot seems to know that. So he forces a landing by his family farm, only to find everything is overgrown, and these bat wolf type creatures are attacking him, and they seem very feral and barbarous where they hadn't been before. They used to be very peaceful. When they make it to the human colony, they are told they're not allowed to have weapons, and they're attacked, and things go horribly wrong, and we're left with a bit of a cliffhanger ending. It looks like the locals are pretty hostile. For the interested parties, this one does come with a card wedged in where the staple is. It's a scratch-off thing with a trading card attached. Make sure your copy has that if you're a big completionist. Overall, the story is good. It's interesting. It jumps right into it. It doesn't give you time to really get to know the characters, but you do get a little bit about Dr. Grange. His mysterious captain, however, is very much just mysterious and busty because they knew how to draw people back in the 90s. The art is a little rough. It does need a little refinement, but overall, it's still better than most of what Marvel's putting out today. So I'm actually going to recommend this. I thought it was fun. They drop you right in the middle of a story where you don't know much about Grange, but you know something's going on, and you're gonna find out at the same rate he does, and it looks pretty interesting. So I'm intrigued to see where it goes, and I'm gonna recommend this. I thought it was fun. That's gonna do it for this one. Thank you so much for listening and supporting the channel. If you enjoyed the video, please hit the like button and don't forget to subscribe so you don't miss future reviews. If you want to help the channel in other ways, the links are in the description, and as always, we hope to see you on the next one.